2 of episode number 44 of Outlaw PD Gaming, WWE Champions 2021. If you missed part 1, or you're watching out of order, what we did tonight so far is we reached VIP level 4. This allows us to take part in hard mode matches. For example, we'll go look at this. Well, that's on normal, but we have access to hard mode matches without getting 3 stars on normal mode, and they're unlocked as well. I don't need to get to the end of Los Angeles before doing Las Vegas. So that allowed me to finish off Summer Showdown Tour Chapter 6 Hard Mode and Summer Tour Albuquerque Chapter 6 Hard Mode. So now we're going to keep using this VIP because we only have it for 24 hours to try to get some other things done. We're going to try some of the matches here in the Mickey James Tour. Now this one needs a showboat, so my best option is Becky. My only other showboat is Paige, who is 2-star silver. Becky's 2-star gold. Nice cascade there. We'll go ahead and do the destroy first. We know we're going to get these 4. Now, I don't have any reinforced gems. This only does 593, so we'll sit on that for a moment. Actually, how much? It only costs 6. I will sit on it for 1 turn. Okay, it's not a submission, so okay, we want those greens. Well, actually, it's not going to matter because she has a submission ready, so got to use it now. take his big cascade. Fortunately, not going to be able to use the moves that come from it. At least not immediately. Yeah, that wasn't bad. We got out of it. We can survive this. Canadian backbreaker, gonna put some cross breaks on. There, just the one. And I think we're in good shape here. Set those there. And break those four. $5,000 to go. Two random into yellow. $2,000 left. Okay, she has her submission again, so we need to use both. All right, we got her in danger. Now we just... That was dumb. I should have put it over that so that I didn't have to worry about that, but mistakes were made. So 54-40. $13.27. I'm going to have like... a dime's worth of health left, but that's all you need. One hundred health left, but it's a win. They don't have to be pretty. Sometimes they just have to be wins. Anyway, seeing how I struggled with that match, the VIP isn't going to really do me much good. Because I'm going to get crushed. Nice start there. We'll have the yellows next turn anyway, so we'll go ahead and we'll try to leave them. Now we need to get the green so that we can get some reinforced gems onto the board. With all the yellows I broke on the last two turns, that ended up being a waste. I could have used the move just for the little bit of damage and had it charged back up by now that I'm ready to use the green move. Yeah, she'll kick out of this, but we're looking in all right shape, and these two yellow gems could make sure of it. Okay, she's in danger. I think this cascade will do it. I'm looking for yellows and purples, and here's some greens. Make some yellows here. We'll go ahead and use this move now. Put them in the bottom. The likelihood of them being broken before next turn are not that good. Sharpshooter. Only two turns, so annoying, but now that part's annoying. Now there's certain coaches like MVP that reduce the length of submission turns for the user. So like Striker Flair does it for strikers. So if you were using Trish, you could use him as a coach and lower the amount of turns, and that way you'd be guaranteed to get the leftover power gems. Okay, we'll take these greens. Set up my reinforced gem move. Okay, I'm in danger, so now it's a race. This will get me two purples. I'm much closer to that move. But what luck was that? Okay, so 5, 10, 8. Where to put these? Okay. $400 to go. I don't do $400. Okay. Few Mickey shards, something. Now we move on to the open portion of the tour. Bonus points for using Alexa, and there are some bonus points for using Becky in the summer portion, or in the side nodes of the easier normal portion of the store. I'm just going to go with Natalia and just run as long as I can. bring over Woods to help her two moves there. Still a little bit of that health back. This could be a WrestleMania preview match right here. Natalia and Nia in the ring together. Like looking at myself in a mirror. Nice looking board here. Lots of purple and red. Lots of green for her. Everybody's happy. Sharpshooter victory. If you want to hear mine and my wife's predictions for the Fastlane pay-per-view on Sunday, check out part one of this episode. We have them there. Looking at the list, we only agree on two matches, the Nia Shayna versus Sasha Bianca match and the Alexa versus Randy match. Stratus faction. Nice bit of cascading there. But easily kicked out of. Sharpshooter for the win. All right, set up again. So put her into danger. And the sharpshooter is ready. That's just... Clothesline and pin also works. Now I can be a little bit risky here, and because I don't have to worry about the VIP or the three stars, I have the VIP. We will use two heals here, though. Lots of options on this board. Here comes Lana with her endless slaps, but she's putting purple on the board, so who am I to complain? Another superstar with a one-cost move there. Normally pretty good. And we're in great shape here. Don't need the submission. All right, a match against the man next. Very quick match. Nice shard bag there for Mickey James as a reward. Another one coming. So with both links, moves start with one more move point. So we'll go with the PG one, since Paige has slightly more health than the other three. Not that we expect any tags to be made. Big start by both. This is what we call dropping bombs. Belly to belly. It needs color turn gems to be effective. And since there aren't any, we'll just take a little bit of that health right back. And set up a clothesline for the win. Nice. So we did three star our way all the way through that one. So hard wouldn't have been an issue. Ones will be a little bit more difficult, but should be handleable. I'm not sure if that's a word, but sounds like it should be one. Handleable. sharpshooter to end it. Or not end it. If I'd used the driver before the sharpshooter, I would have been good. Let's see if we could still... Oh, yeah. Still fine. Hey, the 42nd rank Fusinators are looking for someone. If you have a really good account and you're looking for a faction, check them out. No purples or reds this time, but you get a nice cascade to start anyway. It's fine. I'll take these reds if you don't want them. It's fine. I'll take these reds if you don't want them. So in mere matches like this, it's just a matter of who gets ahead on moves. So I'm going to get the pin here. So she's going to get her submission first. And the question becomes, can she get back to it before I get to mine? I have this wild card sitting there, so let's see if we can keep it together. And we can't. But we can still set up three purples. So she'll steal health, and then I'll steal it right back, slap on a sharpshooter, and move on. Well, actually, maybe not. 49. Oh, yeah. Not bad, not bad. She has both her blue moves ready. This one's not starting off the best. Cycling through all three moves. Get the sharpshooter on here to slow down her progress a little bit. Gonna need a little bit of luck here. And that wasn't quite the luck I was hoping for. $29,000. She's gonna get all three moves here. Two moves to go. Seven, one move to go. And that's going to definitely do enough. But that was all right progress. So let's go take a look at what we won. I got five pulls once we reach league level 10. So by the time that comes up, we may have like eight or nine pulls. So let's head into the store, get our free... Showdown Ballad Rizzolito back. Alrighty. Sounds fancy. I'll take my MVP free claimed pack. Apparently I've forgotten to get a couple of them. Next, we'll go into the faction here. League 25, that ain't bad. Get my rewards. Always be expeditioning. Look at all these coins. They're going to come in handy. $1.7 million coins. Okay. Let's go open up our prizes. 52 of them. Sting Hall of Fame Ultra Shard bag. 150. Wow. Almost doubled what I had there. Three to 20. Got 15. Anything but red. Okay. Right, a lot of tokens, some TPs, some good stuff here. Keeping the future bright. All right. Yeah, I think we'll do a few matches here in Philadelphia and then call it a night. Get a little bit more benefit from our VIP for the 24 hours. Now, I don't know what I have planned for tomorrow, if anything. I think it's supposed to be a nice day. But if I don't, or if I need a break, maybe I can hop on and do a little bit more of this VIP touring before these 24 hours are up. I also wouldn't mind getting on and trying to do some of the showdown, but that probably won't happen since my female roster is just so weak. I don't think I'll get very far with, I guess for me it would be Natalia and Bailey. First turn wild cards, such a wonderful thing. Even better is when you get two of them in the first turn. We'll use the blues to stop the pin first. And probably these purples next. Yep. Actually, what the heck was that? Oh, it's going to be a WrestleMania 36 link with Braun Strowman, since they had a match at WrestleMania 36. I've also noticed that at least, Trickster Undertaker has the same WrestleMania 36 link with Gallows. May I imagine he probably has it with Anderson and AJ too. All right. This is a good start. He's going to get the tag here, but. Oh, that was unfortunate. He's going to have his finisher ready. All right, that might not have been the best time for a tag there. Let's see if we can sneak a pin out of this, though. We did. Alrighty. I was hoping to get all the way through Philadelphia, but hitting that proverbial wall. So, one quick look at the roster here, and there's lots of people that can be have some upgrades done to them. Right there, the three that we knew we were working on, though, they don't have anything going right at the moment. We will go ahead and oh, we'll wait till we need it, but still need black for him. We want to get him to 2,500 so that we get the next MP bonus. Similarly, we want to do the same thing with Woods. He should be in here somewhere. There he is. Looks doable, though. So Woods has 2247. He's maxed on level, but he has three level six moves. Whereas Bray was 2020 with three level six moves and 10 levels to go. So I'm imagining they'll both have to get to three stars. But seeing there, we almost got all the necessary items for Bray. So just need to get some black TP and might be a possibility. All right. Thank you for watching part two of this episode. I hope you enjoyed it. You got to see the importance of knowing if you're not spending money for the VIP, utilizing your VIP to the best of your ability when you get it. If you see that you're getting it, plan to do things that would normally be out of reach and try to get them out of the way. I mean, who knows how much time I would have needed to get these two if I had to go through every single one of those road matches and, well, first going through all the normals to get them to three stars and then going all the way through the road of hard to reach each of them. So getting them out of the way was a nice benefit. As gets League Level 10 into reach. Next weekend, there hopefully will be a faction feud, and I can get those last five. And then those three Blitz matches or whenever I want. So thank you for watching. If you missed any episodes, check them out on YouTube. tinyurl.com/outlawpdgaming will get you there. If you want to get in touch with me, I can be reached on Discord, Outlaw PD number 3842. If you have a moment, please give my videos a thumbs up or leave me some comments. I also appreciate anyone that will follow me. Thank you to Carly Ann for her follow this evening. I hope everyone stays safe and healthy and enjoys the Fastlane pay-per-view on Sunday. If I don't get on this weekend, I will talk to you again Tuesday night, 8 o'clock Eastern. Thank you for watching and have a great morning now. Good night, everyone.